Hey guys, let's talk about episode 2 of Cardcaptor Sakura Clear Card Hen. And I must say, I was pleasantly surprised with this episode. To be honest with you, I thought that Clear Card was going to throw us in the middle of the action with not much time to show us their lives, their daily lives. And I was completely wrong, and I'm kind of thankful for that. Episode 2 felt a little fillerish. But at the same time, it was so heartwarming, and it's so nice to see those characters we love so much in different activities. So the first half of the episode was just Sakura with her friends at school in different scenarios, in different situations. Shiharu in this episode was golden. I loved her, and I loved her scenes. We also had nice scenes with Yamazaki, Naoko, Xiaoran, and obviously Tomoyo. Tomoyo was the center part of this episode, and her character is very nice. I'm still adapting to her voice, to be really honest with you guys, since I'm accustomed to her Brazilian voice. So for me, her voice sounds way too cutesy in Japanese, so I'm still getting used to it. It's not a bad voice. Obviously, it's not a bad voice, but it really feels different from what I'm used to when it comes to Tomoyo. Her Brazilian voice is very cute too, but not as much as the Japanese one. So yeah, in this episode we've had great scenes, and we had even a scene that I was really, really not expecting, which was Sakura and Tomoyo doing Shiharu's cheesecake recipe. The drawings were so cute. They were all in chibi forms and so on, and Chiharu was telling the recipe. They were reading the recipe, obviously, but the way the episode showed Chiharu in her chibi form reading the recipe, telling us the recipe, and the girls doing it, it was so cute and it was so nice. I think that this scene was a little longer than I would want, but it was golden. It was really nice to see that. I also loved the scene when Toya and Yukito came home. Both of them, they do such a great duo. But it was interesting, not in a good way. It was kind of strange to see that they're so intertwined, and their relationship is so their relationship is already established. So I felt that it was a little strange that they didn't even interact. We didn't see their interaction. They were obviously going to interact a lot since Yukito was going to spend the night with Toya. But we didn't see much interaction between them. But we saw lots of interaction between Toya and Sakura. That interaction that we are already used to from the original anime. And it's nice to see that they haven't changed. And also, Toya suspecting Kero is golden. Toya suspecting Kero is always golden. And the way they handled it in this episode was also amazing. I think that the only letdown of this episode to me was the card, the magical part. So Sakura was discussing this disappearance of her cards, the clearance of her cards, I don't even know how to call it, with Tomoyo and Xiaoran. They both gave their opinions, but there was no real consensus. And we, the viewers, we don't know what's really going on with those cards. And I'm talking about us, the anime viewers, because I have read like 2 or 3 chapters of the manga, but I don't remember anything. So I don't know what's going on in the manga. And please don't leave spoilers. And so I think that this leaving us in the dark is obviously a good way to keep us hooked in the series, even though the series gets us hooked with lots of other things that we love about Cardcaptor Sakura. And but the part, the capturing part and the card, the magical part in this episode was a little bit of a letdown. So Sakura, Tomoyo and Kero, they were in Sakura's bedroom. Sakura was trying new clothes, and that's obviously golden, because that's part of a magical girl thing, and that's obviously a Tomoyo thing, and it's also amazing. It's one of the greatest parts of Sakura. I love all the costumes, and I love how all the costumes are great looking, and they always change. So it's a different thing from the usual magical girls that have the same costumes in every episode, obviously, and Sakura has different costumes, and Clamp is great at designing costumes. We have to give it to Clomp because they're amazing. And so Sakura was trying a new costume, and then the room transformed into a white box and they couldn't get out of it. But it was interesting the way Tomoyo found a way to make the box pop. But I thought that Sakura was going to use the Gale card in some way and try to do something. But no, we had nothing. Tomoyo simply popped that box and they were able to capture. Sakura was able to capture the Siege card. And I didn't really understand what that card does. That card traps someone inside a box? Is that it? Is that the only thing that card does? Knowing card capture Sakura, I don't think so. So I really hope Sakura uses that card in a special way in the future. And we also had a kind of a premonition of what's to come with Ariel not talking to Sakura and he wants to talk to her at the right time. Why is that? I have no idea, and to be honest, I'm very curious. And there's also a hint on Shaoran, and his actions are a little blurry. He seems to be a little suspicious of something. So, I don't know. I feel very suspicious as well as a viewer, and I kind of feel afraid. Because, you know, I don't want anything bad to happen to Sakura. And knowing the Tsubasa event, and knowing that the card capture Sakura crosses with Tsubasa in one point of the story, and I particularly dislike that part very much, I don't want anything bad to happen to Sakura. Anyway, guys, that's it for this episode. Please leave a comment with your opinions on episode 2. Let's talk, let's discuss about it. Thank you so much for watching, and until next time, bye-bye!